Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America.
And to the republic for which it stands, one nation,
under God, indivisible, and
liberty and justice for all.
And now, our feature presentation.
Today's episode includes SGA info, fun stuff, you'll see, and a spotlight on a unique student. Hope you enjoy the show.
Hey guys, it's Zoe, your videographer, and I'm here to talk to you about one of the most hectic weeks for SGA, and that is homecoming week. I'm just going to go ahead and lay out the week because I'm a very visual person, so hopefully this will be very helpful for you. On Sunday, we do not have anything going on, so make sure that you catch up on your homework and you get ready for homecoming. On Monday through Friday, we are selling homecoming tickets in the SGA office, which is to the right when you walk in through the main doors, for all the freshmen that don't know. Tickets are going to be $20 each, and the first 75 people are going to get a free t-shirt. So go ahead and come visit us at lunch and get your homecoming tickets. Now, on Monday through Friday, again, we are going to have Spirit Week. So Monday is Maryland Monday, Tuesday is Tropical Tuesday, Wednesday is Pajama Wednesday, Thursday is Tie-Dye Thursday, and Friday is Class Colors Friday. So make sure you're wearing Maryland colors on Monday. The next thing that's happening on Monday and Wednesday is the Courtyard Games. These are going to take place in the courtyard during lunch. On Monday, we are going to do Cornhole, and on Wednesday, we are going to do Cup Pong. But if that's canceled, we are going to play Spike Ball. So go ahead and come visit during those days at lunch. On Thursday, we have homecoming corners, which for the freshmen that don't know, there are different corners that are going to be in the small gym from 2:45 to 9 o'clock that everyone can come in and visit and see what all the different classes did for their homecoming themes. On Friday, we are going to have a pep rally at 2 o'clock. Please stay for the entire thing. It's very rude to leave early. The parade is going to be at 4:30, which you get to see different clubs. It's going to take place in front of the school. And each of the clubs are just going to like go around and you can see everyone and it's just going to be super fun. And then of course on Friday night in the lights is our blackout game. Make sure you're there and wearing black. And then of course on Saturday is homecoming. I'm sorry that this wasn't in the shot. But yeah, in case you guys have any questions, there are going to be posters in the main lobby and around the school. So make sure that you guys keep your eyes open. It's going to be a super fun week and I hope you guys enjoy your weekend.
Good morning. My name is Akhtar Hoshan, and I am junior here at Kunshasart High School. I'm from Bangladesh, which is next to India and Pakistan. Every day after school, I work at Giant in Gaithersburg, and in the weekend, I work McDonald's. The money I save help pay for college, but I eat health for supporting my family. Also, I send $100 per month to help a small school back home. Some school in Bangladesh, they paid by government, but many school paid by local citizens or community. The poor communities struggle to keep their schools open. Some did not have enough teachers and others can't afford to pay their teacher they have. Many schools have to close. The education I am getting from here, America has made me want to help them pay for their school back to home in my Bangladesh. You can also send money on your own to UNICEF, which helps developing nations build school. Thank you.
From Interact Club.
Interact works on planning community service and international service events and fundraisers. It is a fun way to meet people and earn SSL hours. Everyone is invited. An upcoming event will be Oktoberfest, where we're doing arts and crafts activities with kids. We need volunteers this Sunday, October 14th,
from 12 to 5 p.m.
there are hourly shifts. Join now at the remind code at InteractQL. SSL forms are available upon completion of the activity at Oktoberfest.
And Mr. Lee is who we share our room with. Say hello, Mr. Lee.
Hello, how you doing?
Luckily, we don't have to pay rent, because that would be terrible.
And here is where we speak to all of you on this handy-dandy landline.
This is the button we press to get all the news out to you Cougars. If you don't remember the Pledge of Allegiance, like I often don't, it's posted right here, all convenient-like. I look at it daily.
When I'm Mr. Delacon, I'm in charge of bell schedules this year, then adjusting the bells so that they ring on the appropriate times.
This is our bell system here. This is
where the magic takes place, you know. So this is our bell system, and this is also where they do morning announcements. So schedule one is a regular bell schedule. So for schedule two, QOU, that means on a Thursday we have QOU, then we change the bell just for that independent day.
Miss Kalel thinks we're 5-year-olds.
Aw, come on over. We'll make some cookies, and we'll get in our jammies, and we'll have a little nap time. It'll be awesome.
What do you teach at QO? Aren't you rich? Forbes magazine? Unfortunately, no.
Every time I hear Miss Chambers Lazio's voice, I start to fall asleep. Well, it's always a better day when you don't show up.
Didn't Miss Justillian teach Pitbull in Miami? Mr. Worldwide?
What was it like filming on the set of hit 1998 Disney movie, Mulan?
Say that again. I'll make a band out of you.
So, Venom. Venom is an origin story for the popular Marvel Comics character, with Tom Hardy in the title role as Eddie Brock in Venom. It also stars Riz Ahmed, Michelle Williams, and Reed Scott. If you're looking for a movie with basic stepping stones, such as tonal consistency, sensible editing, or good acting choices, this really is not the movie for you. This movie switches genres seemingly at will. Nearly every scene feels like the director forgot to yell action, so the cameraman started filming halfway through the take, and half of Tom Hardy's performance is reminiscent of 1990s Jim Carrey in the worst way possible. I was audibly laughing throughout the first act of the movie because it was simply that bad. I'm not even going to mention how it almost completely betrays its source material. However, when the Venom symbiote is introduced, the movie becomes A, coherent, and B, really enjoyable, actually. The symbiote is by far the best character in this movie. Funny, yet intimidating, and a few memorable moments. Think Audrey 2 from Little Shop of Horrors, but without plans of global conquest. And besides one particularly odd moment with the symbiote Michelle Williams, you'll... trust me, you'll know if you saw the movie. But overall, it improves. Overall, I'd rate this a... I'd say 6.5 out of 10? Yeah, 6.5. And if you're looking for a fun, at times, but not necessarily substance-filled movie, go see it!
Hi, I'm Lainey.
And I'm Max.
We graduated in 2016.
And I just want to say that if you don't fall in love with Mr. Rohrer's class, you might just fall in love in his class.
We go to the University of Maryland, and I'm involved in Greek life.
And I'm a part of a creative writing program. And we love it.